We check in with Matt Renew from the Copper Superpipe. Phil Lindemann with your news from Avalanche Physical Therapy on Crystal 93. First, our snowpack is smoldering just north of Silverthorne.
This season's kind of looking scary. There's currently two fires burning under the snow in Summit County.
That was Sheriff Jamie Fitzsimons on the Crystal Morning Show today, sharing bizarre observations from a federal fire official.
These things are still smoldering under the snow, and we're watching them. We're sending people up there every couple days to watch them, to see where they're skunking around underneath, because there isn't that massive, heavy, wet snowpack.
Late on Tuesday, firefighters in Carbondale extinguished a small grass fire started by a ruptured gas tank at the base of a hill usually covered in snow.
There is no, again, normal fire season.
Local and federal fire officials had their first wildfire meeting this week, looking ahead to a season that could be as dry as 2018, when the Buffalo Fire threatened Wilderness and the Lake Christine Fire destroyed homes in Basalt. For just the third time in 6 decades, the National Repertory Orchestra in Breckenridge has a new music director, Michael Stern.
The National Repertory Orchestra has for 60 years been a rather extraordinary contributor to the musical life of this country.
Stern comes to the NRO from the Kansas City Symphony, taking over for longtime director Carl Topolo.
It's absolutely remarkable when you consider how many musical lives he's touched.
Stern is working now on the NRO summer program, trying to keep his musicians out and under Breck's big blue sky.
At a time when playing outdoors is not only the desirable thing to do from an artistic experience, but also a safe way to gather, then it's a perfect fit.
Learn more at nromusic.org. Crystal 93 correspondent Matt Renew of 9 News was in Copper today, hanging in the halfpipe with Team USA free skiers.
Copper's this season, more than ever, sort of been ground zero and the hub of training for a lot of the U.S. ski and snowboard team.
For the first time in decades, Breckenridge has no halfpipe, putting Copper square in the limelight.
The free ski team has really taken roots up there with that half pipe that they built so early on. And if you look around, there's really not a lot of half pipes around that any of these skiers can be in.
After weeks of training, athletes are itching to compete at X Games Aspen next weekend, where the roar of the crowd will be missed.
You talk to these free skiers and you talk to these snowboarders, and when they drop into the pipe, hearing the crowd and hearing that roar amps them up more than the music they're listening to. And so I think that's going to be an X factor at the X Games.
The X factor for reporters like Matt is access. He's been allowed to shoot footage of training, but face-to-face interviews are rare to protect athlete health. In sports, the Avalanche play the Kings tonight at 8. Over in Europe today, Chloe Kim qualified first at the opening World Cup halfpipe event of the season. Breck snowboarder Taylor Gold made the men's final. Dylan's Chase Blackwell barely missed the cut. Finals are Saturday. Team USA ski racers Ryan Cochran-Siegel and Travis Ganong finished top 10 at World Cup downhill training in Austria today, and Breezy Johnson was second at women's downhill training in Switzerland. Racing begins tomorrow. And in local sports, brought to you by American Family Insurance, the Weiss Agency, the Fat Bikes are back in Breck this weekend. Pat Reyes of Gold Run Nordic Center.
Westy's out there right now checking out the course. He's going to mark it tomorrow, and we'll have all the bikers here out on Saturday.
The upcoming race is one big loop, starting at the Nordic Center before leaving the groomers for Gold Run Road, Fall Classic, Hard Luck, and Dry Gulch. You've got all day Saturday to race. Sign up at mavsports.com. Phil Lindemann with your news from Avalanche Physical Therapy on Crystal 93.